The next geom that I want to talk about is the AB line geom. It adds a line to a plot, and very often that's something that you want to do. Yeah, you want to show where a threshold is, so you add a horizontal or a vertical line on your plot that corresponds to that threshold. It's something that you often want, and you have three different geoms for that. So this will add a line to a plot, this will add a horizontal line to a plot, and this will add a vertical line. So this is any line that is not horizontal or vertical. It has two obligatory arguments. You have to set them. You have to set a slope, how steep should the line be, and an intercept, where does it cut the y-axis. For the H line geom, the horizontal line geom, you have to tell him where it cuts the y-axis, where to put it, at which y-value. And the same thing for the vertical line. Here you have to tell him which x value he should put it. These are all lines, so all the typical things that you can set for a line also apply here. Now, this is not to be confused. These geoms are not to be confused with the smooth geom. The smooth geom can also add a line to a plot, but the smooth geom will add a regression line to the plot. So you don't define here how the line goes, it's your data that will define how the line goes. So here you add a line that you define yourself, and here it's the result of a regression. This is of course also a line. You can set the typical things. I want to mention here something. When you use the smooth geom, he can also draw confidence bands around this regression line. So that means that although it's a line, you can still fill here. Fill the area that is between or that is defined by the confidence bands around your regression line. What is also a very important argument here is the methods argument. So by default, he will not fit a line to your data, but he will fit a curve to your data. So he will do nonlinear regression using the lowest method. If you want a line, you want to do linear regression, you will have to set method to linear model or generalized linear model. So LM or GLM. The default will not be a line, it will be a curve. If you want to show a confidence band around your regression line, it's this argument that you have to manipulate. So by default, it's true, so he will show it. If you don't like it, you just put SE equal to false. And with the level argument, you can set the confidence level of this band. So the default is, of course, 95%, because most people use that. Yeah, so for adding a regression line, you need a different geom than for adding just a line to your data. So here you can see the difference between these things, because many people confuse it. So you have the AB line geom, which will add a line to your data. Typically, you use it to add a diagonal. Sometimes points or data has to follow the diagonal, and then, well, this is what you need. If you want a horizontal line to say, hey, the threshold is here, then it's the H line geom that you have to use. And the y-intercept will specify where it's located. So here, this one is located here at value 1 on the y-axis. So here you define your lines. With this case, what you do is you add a smooth geom with a linear model method. So what he's adding here is the regression line. The blue thing is the regression line, and it's calculated based on your data points. So it's the line that best fits your data points. And you see here, by default, he puts that confidence band. So this is the confidence interval for every x value that he puts on the plot. And then apart from these three geoms, you also have a line geom. So not a B line or H line, but just a line geom. This is to make a line plot. So you have data, these are your values, and you link your data by a line. Yeah, you draw a line between your data points. So these are all ways to include lines on plots, but they all do something different. So I will go back to R. So an example here, I make a plot. Here we are. So I make a plot of my empty cars data. And now I want to add a line to this plot, because I think that the points should follow that line. So how to do this? Well, you just add an AB line geom. And for this AB line geom, you define an intercept where it crosses the y-axis at y value minus 35. That's what I define here. And you define a slope for the line. So for every increase of x, how many increases of y should he do? That's what the slope defines. So when I just do this, he adds the line to the plot. It doesn't cross the y-axis at minus 35. Why not? It's well because you don't see everything here. So your x-axis doesn't start at zero. At x value zero, it should cross the y-axis at minus 35. So if I want to see that, I have to make the range on my x-axis a bit larger. How to set the range of the x-axis in a very simple way? By adding, of course, a layer. And the layer is called xlim. Yeah, it's the range for the x-axis. So start your x-axis at 0 and end it at 6. So if I now do the whole thing, you get this. And you see that indeed, at x value 0, you cut the y-axis at minus 35. So this is a line that I have added. I have defined how it should go. It's not a regression line.